Hi everyone, I'm Shauna and welcome to my channel. Today it's time for another Project Pan update. Update number 7. I just went to go look at my other video to make sure we're on number 7 because I often forget what number. So we are not gonna dilly-dally, we are just gonna get into the updating. All of the products mentioned in this video will be listed in the description box below. One of you mentioned a couple updates ago that it would be nice if I said the products, and I agree with you 100%. I've just noticed since that comment that I forget. So my solution to that is say when I remember, and either way, all the products are listed down there in case I forget. And
let's
start first with the First Day Beauty Poreless Matte Primer. You can see a little bit of use there. I think there's a chance I'm actually a little bit farther into it, but I'm not 100% sure because I am relying on the, like on the sun to be able to see inside. It's looking more just a little bit like there, but I'm not totally sure. So I'm just gonna leave it the mark as it is. There's definitely some progress going on here, and do remember that this was completely full when we first introduced it to the project, and this wasn't even introduced at the beginning. So will this be done by December? Probably not, but I think by then we'll at least be halfway through, or at least I hope. Listen, you can't be mad at me. This has not died yet. You can see fully through the sides. They're all kind of scraped out, but you can see that there's some left in the bottom. This and the concealer are living to see another month. Like I had said in previous updates for the foundation, I do mix it with other products, which is why I've been using so little, but I did use it as an all-over foundation for the first time last week, and I really liked it for a natural look. So I'm hoping to use more of that this next month, but it's living to see another day if you want to roll your eyes. Did you see it coming? Because I felt like everybody saw it coming. Every month, I am so convinced that this is the last month for this product. I almost don't trust my opinion on this anymore. So I'm like, yeah, it's gonna be this month. It's gonna be this month. And then literally, what are we? We're just entering October 10 months later. It's still, this will be finished by the end of the year if I have to wear this all over my face for weeks straight in December. I'm hoping not, but I'm really, really hoping that this will be gone next month, but you know, we'll never see. We'll have to see. The concealer, it's kind of the same story. I have no idea how this is lasting so long, but I think that this is actually going to be longer than a month. I think we're going to see this concealer go to the end of the project, and my mind always goes back and forth with this, and it has kind of all year. My current feeling is that if it's not finished by December, I think I'm going to throw it out. I just don't think it's the formula for me. So, well, obviously we'll take it as it comes in December, but that's kind of where I'm sitting with that. There, I did introduce a couple more foundations last month. The first was this Tarte Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Full Coverage Foundation. This one does have air in it as well. I do think I have less on here than what is showing. There is the tallies right here. I hope you can see that properly. If not, you know the drill. Pictures on the screen. I think I'm actually farther, but it's unclear how much of what's in here is air. I think that if I use this for all of October and November, I think it could be finished, but the shade lasting that long is unclear. So I'm hoping to at least be able to finish the months with this. And I don't know if this will be a rollout kind of situation like some of the other products, but we'll take it as it comes. It's at least gonna stay in for October. And that progress is, I'm really happy about that. Like that's really, really significant. So I'm very happy. The other little foundation, or it's this BB cream. It's the e.l.f. just BB cream. There's a lot of air in here. It's kind of like this was at the beginning. I don't know if I'll be able to tell anything for the next, you know, month, maybe even longer. So this is just, you know, it's going, it's here. That's the update. Okay, the powder. I just dropped the puff everywhere. There is actually a lot more product in here than I thought. Huge pan. I believe that I can roll this out for next month. I think that it will take me a month to finish it. And that will be really perfect timing because, again, my skin tone is going to be getting lighter. So I'm very much hoping I can finish this in October to have it rolled out and bring in one more powder to hopefully use up another powder by the end of the year. But that, you know, that's iffy. I'm really proud of this. This has been a lot of regular use. And you can see that. The next powder product is my Colourpop Bronzer. I have really expanded the pan in here. It's getting much bigger. I'm really proud of that too. I've been really kind of going in and even using this as eyeshadow a couple of days too. I don't think I'll finish this in October, but I think this could be a November finish. And that's really exciting. Guys, there's just, I feel like this was the update of progress. And I did finish one thing, but I think a lot of the stuff in here is like kind of setting me up to finish for next month. At least I hope. So we'll see. But again, that's some really nice progress. And you know, project pans are, yeah, they're about finishing your products and getting use out of your products. But at the same time, you can't finish them unless you use them and you see that use. I also want to enjoy using my products, and sometimes I get a little distracted and it's like a race to the finish, but I don't just want to be like scraping my brush in here, get all the bronzer on my face, time to finish the project. I want to enjoy it too. So I really am trying to find this balance of using my products, finishing them, but kind of enjoying that process. The last powder product is going to look a little different. It is my blush. I did repress this and I kind of covered that repressing on my Instagram. This is the second time I've ever repressed anything. If you remember, the first time I repressed something was that bronzer back in, February or March. This one did go better, but let's just appreciate this. There's so much freaking product in here. It's basically like a brand new full pan of face product. It's insane how much product there was. This is not going anywhere this year. I don't actually think I'll hit pan anytime soon this year. I think that it's just go strong until the end of the year, into the next year. And after repressing this, it changed color. You'll see a picture from before I hit pan. From before I repressed it, sorry. It was looking much dustier. And as I had said in previous videos, updates, I don't know why I'm holding it like this. You've already seen it. The color had changed and it wasn't performing like I remembered. After repressing it, the outer color is much more vibrant and less dusty and muted because that's kind of what the top looked like. Like there was literally a layer of dust on it. And the color is actually much more shimmery now that it's repressed. I did like the color more before I repressed it. I wanted to initially declutter it at the end of the year because it was old. Something being old is not a good enough justification on its own to get rid of something. Age is not always an indicator of expiry or something, just being bad. Yes, something has to be old to, you know, be expired or maybe to see mold or bacteria or some kind of change in your makeup. But if your makeup is old and you don't see any of those changes, in my opinion, you're fine. So this is an old product. I think it's, again, I think I've said this before, from around 2014 or 2015. It is potentially older, but it's a powder product. It's not smelling. There was a color change that has disappeared after repressing. So I think I'm going to keep it past December, because it's looking fine. And I don't want to just declutter something for the sake of decluttering. Oh, it's old, so I have to get rid of it. That's not the way I operate around here. Anyways, onto the lip products and then the face products. So the first thing I want to update you on is the E.L.F. Jelly Pop Lip Gloss. This has huge use. Huge. I think it's possible to use this by next month, but it's also possible for me to finish it in November. I definitely think this will be out by the end of the year, but it's really questionable on whether or not I could finish this for next month. Okay, the lip liner and the lipstick. The lipstick, I am seeing regular use. I have the little cart here, but you'll be able to see it much better in the close-up pictures. But I did use it, and the progress is steady. So that was Bite Sugarcane, but that's going okay. There's also really good use in the lip liner. If you just look at that card, the Ofra, I've used so much since the beginning of the year, but I don't actually think I'll finish this in 2020. The lip product situation is, I've said it and I'll probably say it for every subsequent update, usage is not the same when you're wearing a mask. The only time I'm really wearing lip products is when I'm filming or maybe even around my house. It's a weird time and I feel like I'm not alone in this. So if things are a little bit slower, that's fine. It is what it is. The last thing is the Marc Jacobs lip gloss in Moonglow. It's certainly coming. There is definitely some light in here, and I keep going back and forth on whether I could use this by the end of the year. I'm not sure, we'll see. I really think that I need to implement a tally sheet again for my Project Pan items, and I think it'll be easier now that I'm introducing my 100 uses Project Pan. That's gonna need some tallies as well. So I'm gonna restart the tallies and I can talk to you next month exactly how many times I wore each product. Onto the skincare items. I'm gonna save the rollout for last. I'm gonna quickly talk about my little oil. This is the Tamanu oil. I can see clearly in the light that the product was like at the top of the tally at the beginning of the month, and now at this update, it's at the bottom of the tally. It's pretty, just like a hair underneath. So yeah, there was no need to create a new tally for this. But if you look at it, look at how far I've come since February. That's a ton of use in this product that would never have happened without this project. So I just want to take a minute to be proud of myself for a second on this usage and it also being regular and also pulling this out for a couple of months. So I think it is possible with 3 months left to finish it, but it's going to take some really hard work. And with that, I don't necessarily want to force myself to use something that I'm not really feeling. So when I really want to use it, I'm going to use it, but I want to make sure that it's out. So out on my counter, so I have that option, it's in front of me and I can make that decision instead of just, forgetting about it. The last two products are the masks. This Tatcha mask has way more product in it than I thought. In the last update, I thought that there would be about 4 uses left. No, I kind of think at least 4 this month, maybe even more. There's just the product is at the very bottom, but it's still a lot of product, more than I guess realized. So hopefully this will be used up next month. And then the last thing is the Peter Thomas Roth eye gels. I think I used this 3 times this past month, and it looks like there's about 9 left. So I am going to have to use at least 3 or 4 each month. At least using it 3 times each month for the next 3 months should finish it. And then we'll be all good. I do have masks and other projects, so I'm really glad that this one is almost done and just a couple of uses. And I think that once it's done, I'm not gonna roll in a mask. Maybe I won't roll in anything. We'll see. The last product is the Dr. Brandt Microdermabrasion Exfoliator. I broke the cap on it, so it just like fills back up with air super quick. It's done. It's just kind of filling up with air. There's no more product left in here. It's about time. Not a really great product. So this is finished. I'm rolling it out. And I am rolling in a bit of an interesting product, I think. This is a makeup brush cleaner. This looks absolutely nasty, disgusting. My gross makeup fingers all over it. This is so old. From high school old. I remember purchasing this. It still works. Maybe not as good as it used to. And it is nasty. It's time to get it out. I don't actually know how much I go through a month, but I am going to tally it once this settles from all my like shaking. And I'm going to leave it on my desk. And we'll see. I think it's possible to use this up in 3 months, but I don't really have an idea on that. So that is a new and latest roll-in. Those are all of the products. Just to recap, the items I'm hoping to finish next month are the powder and the lip gloss as well as the mask. Again, these are just hopes. We will see how things go. The foundation feels like, I want to say like I feel like it's going to finish next month, but you never really know with this and my own opinion on it. I also want to bring back the tallies for next month, so I'm going to go set that up after the video. That's the update. Let me know what you thought about the use in the comments down below. I'm just off staring at my products right now. I'm most proud of my bronzer and powder use. That's going to wrap up the video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you again around here soon. Bye.